Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of the Grain Scrapping Machine. Today I'm going to make a gatefold card that I'm going to be using as a Mother's Day card. So let's go ahead and get started. I have a piece of cardstock cut at 8.5 by 4.25. And what I've done is I went ahead and scored it at 2 1/8 and 6 3/8. So again, that was scored at 2 1/8 and 6 3/8, and then it becomes a form of a gatefold card, and it also measures 4 1/4 by 4 1/4. Then I have, for the two panels, I have this shimmery, I don't know if it's going to pick up there, you can kind of see how it's shimmery, it's a cream colored cardstock that is cut at 2 inches by 4 inches, and I have two of those, one for each side panel. And what I'm going to do, well, before I pull out my Texture Boutique, I also, using Simply Charmed, I cut out this heart. I'm hoping, yeah, it'll be fine. It's a little bit big, but I cut it out at the purple one. I cut out at 3.5 inches, and the layer I cut out at 3 1/4. And it's not really a layer type. Let me see. I'll grab my manual here. It's the heart on page 30. And I know a lot of cartridges have hearts on them. I just had this one handy, so I grabbed it. But what I just did is layer two here. And I just cut the basic function, cut out one, hit stop, and then lowered it and cut out the other one. Again, at 3.5 and 3 1/4. And so what I'm going to do with these two side panels, go ahead and move everything aside. I am going to run them through the Swiss Dots Cuddle Bug folder. And I'm just going to go ahead and lay both of these in here. Kind of kill two birds with one stone, per se. Go. And then with the Texture Boutique, you create your sandwich, the black piece, the shim, and the other black piece. And then I'm going to go ahead and run it through. Ooh, sorry. Now we have a beautiful embossed look to our panels. And then the heart, I'm going to run through the Divine Swirl Cuddlebug folder. This one is so elegant looking. I love it. And I'm actually going to move aside my working mat. That way this doesn't roll all over the place. Alright. My working mat back. And there is my heart. Pretty. I love that. Alright, so we'll bring back the base. I'm going to go ahead and adhere down my two side panels. And Now I'm going to open this up. Might be easier to get it on there straight. There we go. Go ahead and adhere this one down. When I stick that one down, I just want to make sure that they line up. Yep. So there is what we have so far. And I'm just going to quickly, one more time, run my bone folder down the sides so that it kind of stays down on its own a little bit better. That nice crease in there. Alright, it looks like that's the best I can get. Ooh, excuse me. Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and adhere my heart down to the shadowed, the kind of shadowed feature. I can get my ETG gun to cooperate with me better. There we go. Perfect. Using a glue dot, I have this little flower embellishment that I got from Michael's in their dollar section. And what I really wanted to do was just put like a ribbon bow right there. But I didn't have any ribbon that really matched very well with the purple that I used. So I thought this would add a little bit something more to the card as well. And before I adhere this down to the card, I'm going to go ahead and put this piece in the center. And this measures 4x4. This is where I'm going to stamp my sentiment, and it just added a little something to the inside of the card. And I thought I had a basic Mother's Day stamp, but I don't. That's one thing that I really need to invest in are some basic sentiment stamps. So I do have one that says Happy Mom's Day, and what I did is I laid it down on my acrylic block. I emphasized the happy part, and then this one says Mom's Day. I guess I could flip it around. And then I had the butterfly with the little trail behind it, and so I just put that in the corner. This is my Memento Black Tuxedo Black ink. And I'm going to go ahead and stamp that right in the middle. Perfect. Alright, now I'll close, and I am going to put adhesive on just half of my heart on the left-hand side. And be pretty generous with this so that it doesn't fall off. Place that in the center. And there is the completed card. Hope you enjoyed this episode of the Green Scrapping Machine, and I will see you next time. Have a great day. Bye!